at the University of New South Wales, in particular at the School of Mathematics and Statistics. My name is Thomas Britz, and I'm going to be looking at problem 27, part A of topic 5, which is about graph theory in the course MATH1081, which is discrete mathematics. So in this problem here, we're looking at a graph and we want to show that it's planar. So that means that we can redraw the graph in such a way that all of the edges are not crossing each other, that none of the edges cross each other. Now you can see here that we've got lines, or the lines representing the edges, that are crossing each other. We've got a crossing there, there, and there. So we have to take this picture of the graph and draw a new picture, a new representation of the graph, in such a way that we don't have any crossings like this. So before we do that, I've got two comments to make. The first is about the type of problem that we have here. We have to show that a graph is planar. So then we just redraw it, and that's fine. You could do it in other ways, but that's a simple way to do it. The other type of problem that you often encounter about planarity of graphs is that you have to show that a graph is not planar. And there you could try to redraw it and say, oh, we can't do it, whatever. But a better way would be to use Kuratowski's theorem. So we have two different types of problems here, or mainly two different types of problems. We have to show that a graph is not planar, in which case you could use Kuratowski's theorem, or that a graph is planar, in which case you just redraw it in a planar way, so that none of the edges are crossing. The second comment is that this graph is a particular graph. It's sort of nearly diabolical, in the sense that if we added one more line, we get a pentagram. And a pentagram, or in other words, K5, the graph, the complete graph on 5 vertices, that's actually not planar. So if you took this new graph here, K5, and tried to redraw it in a planar way, you'd fail. And you're very welcome to try that just to convince yourself. But if we just take one edge out like this, then apparently this is a planar graph, and that's what we have to show. So let's do that. So the way that I think of it when redrawing these graphs is that each of the vertices is like a pin or a nail in a wooden board. And the edges are like rubber bands between the pins. And we take a pin out and move it somewhere else, or we stretch a rubber band and so forth. And it could be pretty cool to have a wooden board with pins and rubber bands and everything. We've got a whiteboard. That'll have to do. So let's do that. Okay, let's draw some vertices. We've got A, B, C. I'm not moving the vertices much at the moment. I'm just being a bit lazy and just drawing the same graph as far as I can until I run into problems. So I'll draw the outer edges first, for instance. That seems to be going well. No crossings there, of course. I can draw these two edges, for instance. Let's see. This one and this one. Now I run into trouble because I can't add any more vertices. There are two more. There's from A to E and from C to D. A to E crosses, well, it would cross this one here, and C to D would cross this one here. So what do I do? Well, I can stretch my rubber band, so to speak. I can take this line from A to E and stretch it like this. Now it's all bendy, but it doesn't intersect anything. It doesn't cross any of the other lines, so that's what we want. What about this one from C to D? We can stretch that one too. So here we've got it here, and we stretch it, but that's not going to work because it'll always intersect this line here, A to E. So it'll always cross it. So we have to do something else. So we have to maybe get bend another edge or move one of the vertices or something. So what can we do? Well, we could, for instance, take this one here, B to E, and bend it. So make it go all curvy out there, pull the rubber band, and now there's room for us just to draw the C to D edge, and we're done. We've drawn all of the edges in slightly different ways than before, in such a way that they no longer intersect, they don't cross. So this is a planar representation of the graph. So the graph is planar. And there we go. Now, you might be a little bit annoyed at these bendy lines. If you really want the lines to be straight, then you could ask, well, could we have redrawn it in such a way that the lines are straight? And the answer is, yes, you can. There's a famous theorem, I think by far in the 1920s, if I'm not incorrect, and please correct me if I am, that you can always take a finite graph like this and draw it in such a way, it has to be simple, but apart from that, redraw it in such a way that all of the lines are in fact straight. So, cool. We should be able to do this here too. So how could we do it? Well, if we wanted this bendy line to be straight, then it would be intersecting this and this line. So if we instead got rid of those lines or moved them so that they wouldn't intersect, like this, so put them up here, for instance, then there's suddenly room to straighten out this bendy line. Now we have this edge being all being represented by this straight line here. Well, supposed to be straight, I'm drawing it a little bit messily. Here we should write D, because we've moved D up there. Taken our pin out of the wooden board and placed it up there. Okay, what about this bendy line? Well, we could do the same sort of thing. We could move this vertex in by removing the pin from the board and placing it down somewhere else. Like, for instance, here. So this is, we'll move that vertex C closer. And now we can take this bendy line and straighten it out, like so. And there we go. We have another representation of the graph here that is planar, a planar representation, so none of the edges cross. And you see that they're now all straight lines. Well, they're supposed to be, apart from my bad drawing of them, they're all straight lines, and we're done. So that's another solution. Well, thank you very much.